Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Vivan Education. Today we are going to discuss about class 10th applications of trigonometry exercise 12.2. Exercise 12.1 already we discussed in previous classes. So if you missed that class, I given link in description, you can check that one. Exercise 12.2 is about 4 marks question, which is very important for your examinations. Compulsory you will get a 4 marks question from this exercise 12.2. Okay. So in this total, we are having total 9 sums. We'll discuss one by one here. First question is, a TV tower stands vertically on the side of a road. From a point on the side directly opposite to the tower, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 60 degrees. From another point 10 meters away from this point, on the line joining this point to the foot of the tower, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 30 degrees. Find the height of the tower and the width of the road. And read a question. A TV tower stands vertically on the side of a road. TV tower stands vertically on the side of a road. From a point on the other side, directly opposite to the tower, the angle of elevation of top of the tower is 60 degrees. Clear? From opposite point, if you observe from that one, the angle of elevation of top of the tower is given as 60 degrees. From another point, 10 meters away from this point, take another point, which is 10 meters away from the first point, on the line joining this point to the foot of the tower, the angle of elevation of the tower is how much given? 30 degrees. Now second angle given as here 30 degrees. Then we had to find the height of the tower and width of the road we had to find. We had to find the height of the tower and width of the road. Okay. So for this question, first we had to draw the figure here first. We'll draw a figure first for this given data. So first what he said, a TV tower stands vertically on the side of a road. So drawing a vertical line here. Clear? Considering here, AB is a vertical line, nothing but it's a tower which stands vertically on the side of a road. Is it okay? Then what he said, from a point on the other side, directly opposite to the tower. Here AB is a tower. Now considering a point here which is opposite to the tower. Yes, here it is opposite to the A only right here. Nothing but it's a ground. Okay. So and what he said, the angle of elevation of top of the tower is 60 degrees. Now from this point, the angle of elevation of top of the tower is how much given? 60 degrees. Nothing but it is a ground right first. Now given angle given as how much here? 60 degrees as angle of elevation. Clear? Next what he said, from another point 10 meters away from this point. From this point, again he said take another point which is 10 meters away from this point. Considering here the point which is 10 meters away from this first point. So distance is how much given here? 10 meters. Is it clear? Now considering at this point, first point as C, now this one I'm considering as D. Is it clear? Now said, from the point 10 meters away from this point, on the line joining this point to the foot of the tower. Yes, it is the foot of the tower, right? And the foot of the tower, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower is 30 degrees. Now from this point, the angle of elevation of top of the tower is how much he said? 30 degrees. Given as 30 degrees. Clear? Now what did we do? We had to find the height of the tower and the width of the road. So we had to find the height of the tower and this width of the road. Clear? First we'll write the given data. The question what he given, we'll write here first. So, we'll consider first here. We don't know the height of the tower and width of the road, right? So, we'll consider here. Let the height of the tower So, what is the tower here? AB. is equals to considering here h meters. Now this height I'm considering as what? H meters. Next, width. Let the width of the road. What is it here? AC is equals to considering suppose x meters. This width considering as x meters. We have to find these two now, right? And given angle of elevations given. Given what? Angle of elevations. Elevations from two points. Is given as how much here? 60 degrees and 30 degrees. Right? Given two points. One is 60 degrees and another one is what? 30 degrees. Nothing but what we can say here? Angle BCA. Angle BCA is equals to 60 degrees and angle BDA is equals to 30 degrees. These two are given angle of elevations. Right? Now, we'll consider single triangles to find the values of x and y. First, from triangle BCA, I'm considering first from figure or from triangle BCA. From triangle BCA, what we can say here? If you observe from 60, it becomes what side? Opposite, and it is the adjacent. Side opposite to the adjacent. Which ratio will consider here? We know that tan theta. Tan theta is equals to side opposite to the adjacent. Right? You can say tan theta is equals to side. What is opposite here? AB. Opposite and adjacent. What is adjacent here? AC. Is it clear? And given theta is what is the angle given here? 60. Simply I said tan 60 degrees is equals to AB. What is the value of AB here? We don't know. Assuming as height h by AC. AC also we don't know width of the road considering as x here. Clear? This implies we can say we know that what is the value of tan 60? Tan 60 is root 3, right? Is equals to h by x. Now from this one we had first we'll find the height here. H is equals to how much we'll get here? Root 3 into x doing cross multiplication. So we got h is equals to root 3x meters. This one I'm considering as equation number 1. Is it clear? From triangle BCA, we got the value height is equals to root 3x meters. Now, we'll consider total triangle. What is there? From triangle BDA. Total triangle BDA. Again, what is the angle given here? 30. With respect to 30, it is the opposite and it is the adjacent. Again, side opposite to the adjacent means which trigonometric ratio we had to consider? Tan theta, right? Tan theta. So, tan theta is the question of what is the opposite here? Again, AB by what is adjacent here? Total DA or AD. Right? How will you get DA? By adding DC plus CA. How will you get DA? Here, DA is equals to DC plus CA. Okay? By adding these two, you will get this total DA. And given angle of elevation, second case, how much here? 30 degrees. This implies tan 30 degrees is equals to AB. What is the AB here? H, remember height of the tower, by DA. How will you get DA here? By adding DC plus CA. DC, what is the measure DC here? 10 meters plus CA measure nothing but the width of the road. 10 plus X by 10 plus X. Is it clear? This implies, what is the value of tan 30? Tan 30 is what? 1 by root 3, right? Tan 30 value 1 by root 3 is equals to, from equation 1, what is the value of h here? Root 3x. Root 3x by 10 plus x. Remember here, how you got h value here? Root 3x means from equation 1. You know that from 1 we written h value as root 3x here. Clear? Now, here I am doing cross multiplication here. 10 plus x into 1 is what? 10 plus x is equals to root 3 into root 3, 3 and x. Here doing here, what I am doing here? multiplication of root 3 x into root 3. Root 3 into root 3 becomes how much? 3, and x I'm writing as it is, because we know that root a into root a is equals to a. Clear? That's why root 3 into root 3 how much? 3, and variable is x, I'm writing as it is. Here we had to find the value of x here. Clearly here 3x transposing plus x becomes minus x is equals to 10. Then 3x minus x how much? 2x is equals to 10. This implies we had to find the value of x here. X is equals to 10. Multiplication becomes division by 2. 2 ones and 2 fives are. This implies x is equals to how much we got here? 5 meters. Is it clear? Now see here, we got the value of x here. Now what we had to find? We had to find the value of h. We had to find the value of h because h is the height of the tower. So x equals to 5, substituting in equation number 1. X equals to 5, I am substituting in equation number 1. So first, what is the equation 1 here? H is equals to root 3 into x. Then h is equals to root 3 into x means how much we got here? 5. Then h is equals to 5 into root 3 is what? 5 root 3 meters is the value of h. Clear? Therefore, we can conclude that width of the road, is equals to how much here? How much we got here? X means 5 meters. And total means if you add 10 plus x, nothing but 10 plus 5 is 15. Total if you want means. So we have to find only this AC. So we got here 5 meters. And height of the tower. Is equal to how much we got here? 5 root 3 meters. If you want to find the exact value, just replace the value of root 3. How much? 1.732. You will get the exact value. Or else you can stop here. Is it? It's also correct. Okay. So this is about what? Question number 1. So you had to draw the figure exactly. From this one only we had to find the values. And remember, trigonometric values you have to know compulsory. Okay, if you know sine, cos, tan perfectly, then you will get very easy. Okay, this is about what? Question number 1. Next, question number 2. Question number 2 is, a 1.5 meters tall boy is looking at the top of a temple which is 30 meters in height. From a point at a certain distance, the angle of elevation from his eyes to the top of the crown of the temple increases from 30 degrees to 60 degrees as he walks towards the temple. Find the distance he walk towards the temple. Clear? So once again, read the question. A 1.5 meters tall boy is looking at the top of a temple which is 30 meters in height. Here given two. What he given? Height of the boy and given height of the temple. Right? In height. From a point at certain distance, the angle of elevation from his eye to the top of the crown of the temple increases from 30 degrees to 60 degrees as he walks towards the temple. The angle is increased from 30 to 60 degrees, right? If you move to any object from a certain place, compulsory the angle will be increased, right? Same here. Here also, as he walks towards the temple, the angle is increases from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. Clear? Then find the distance he walked towards the temple. We had to find the distance he walked towards the temple. Right? So, first we'll draw the figure for this given data. So, first what is it? A 1.5 meters tall boy is looking at the top of a temple which is 30 meters height. So first we'll look at a boy here of height 1.5 meters. Suppose here I'm taking here. Considering here AB is a boy, height of the boy. How much? 1.5 meters. Is it clear? Then what is it? Temple is there and the height, how much given? Temple height is 30 meters high. Temple height is 30 meters. Considering CD is a temple height how much? 30 meters. Is it clear? And what he said, the angle of elevation from his eyes to the top of the crown of the temple increases from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. So this is a boy. From his eyes, the top of the temple, nothing but he looking the top of the crown, right? And what is the angle of elevation from his eyes is given as 30 degrees. Looking with eyes, the angle of elevation to the top of the crown is 30 degrees. And he walks towards the temple, right? And he walks towards the temple. And the angle of elevation after walking certain distance, the angle of elevation changes from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. Considering somewhere point here, and it is increases from 30 degrees to 60 degrees. Walking towards the temple, first the angle of elevation is 30 degrees. After walking certain distance, the angle of elevation changes from 30 to 60 degrees. Right? Now what we have to find? Find the distance he walked towards the temple. So we have to find the distance how much he walked towards the temple. Right? So this total term I am considering as ground. Is it clear everyone? So he walked, this one also same. Means from here to here he walked. So let I am considering how much he walked between, right? I am considering x meters as he walked. And this one I am considering as y meters remaining. Is it clear? Or else you can consider this total distance is you can d, then subtract x from d, you will get the answer. Okay? So just as to understand easily, I am considering here walking distance as x, remaining as y. Is it clear? Now we will write the given data. So what he said, given the height of the boy. What we consider here, height of the boy is AB is equal to how much? 1.5 meters. Is it clear first everyone? Next, given what? Height of the temple. Given the height of the temple. Temple we are considering as what here? CD is equal to how much? 30 meters. First I am writing what he given actually, right? Next, given angle of elevations given. Angle of elevations from two points. From two points is how much? 30 degrees and 60 degrees. 30 and 60. Right, nothing but we can say clearly here angle D. So this is what E and this is what F. Clear? So A B C D E F, this is G. Okay, actually this is no need to take here, it is enough. Okay, but we already took ready here. So we'll consider here A B C D E F and G. Now clearly we can say here angle DBG, angle DBG is equals to 30 degrees and angle DFG is equals to 60 degrees. These two are what? Angle of elevations. Now if you observe here, this is the temple and it is the boy, right? And clearly this boy height is equals to till here height of the temple, right? Now first we had to find the remaining height of the temple, because these two heights are equal, nothing but here AB is equals to CG, nothing but now what will happen, this length also 1.5 meters. Now what is the actual height of the temple now here? This is DG is the actual height of the temple now. Clear? Because these two heights are equal, remaining height of the temple is equal to, how will you find CD minus CG? Actual height is what here? CD is the height of the temple. But here AB is equal to CG, because height of the boy till here equal. Now we have to find the height of the remaining temple. We know here CG is equal to 1.5 meters. we have to find what here? DG is equals to how much? From total we have to subtract CG. Then DG is equals to CD minus CG. Nothing but CD is total is 30 meters minus height of the boy is 1.5. Nothing but how much? 28.5 meters. Then DG is equals to 28.5 meters is the height of the temple now. Clear? Here DG is the height of the temple now. Okay? Now coming to here, we don't know, right? So how much he walked, we don't know. Considering here FB is equals to X meters, right? And considering here FG is equals to Y meters. Clear? Yes. What indicates here FB? How much distance he walked towards the temple, right? So now from considering triangle DFG, if you observe from 60 degrees, clearly we know it's the opposite and it is the adjacent side. Opposite to the adjacent, we can consider which ratio? Tan theta we should consider. Then tan theta is equals to what is the opposite here? DG. Side opposite is DG and adjacent is what? FG. Clear? This implies tan theta value how much here? 60 degrees. Is equals to DG is how much? 28.5 by FG is equals to how much? Y. Clear everyone? This one I written here. This implies tan 60 value how much? Root 3 is equals to 28.5 by Y. Now from this one we have to find the value of Y, right? Then Y is equals to how much? 28.5 by root 3. Doing cross multiplication. Root 3 into Y, root 3 Y. Multiplication becomes a division. So root 3 becomes a denominator here. Y equals how much you got? 28.5 by root 3. So doing simplification here. To get the value of Y, 28.5 by root 3. I am racializing the denominator. Nothing but multiplying and dividing with a root 3. Then what will happen? See, Y is equals to 28.5 into root 3 is same. Root 3 into root 3 becomes what? 3. Because we know already root A into root A is equals to how much? A only. Now doing cancellation here. Doing cancellation. 3 1s are 3. 3 9s are 27. 28 means 1 will be left. 1 5 becomes 15. The point is there. 3 5s are 15. This implies Y is equals to how much we got here? 9.5 root 3 meters. Y is equals to 9.5 root 3 meters. Is it clear? So we got the value of what here? Y. Now we have to find the value of X. We have to find the value of X here. So from triangle DBG again with respect to 30 degrees opposite to the adjacent, nothing but again we have to consider tan ratio only. Tan theta is equals to what is the opposite here? Again DG by what is the adjacent? BG, right? What is the meaning of BG here? BG is equals to BF plus FG. Clear? We have to add these two. This implies tan given angle how much here? 30 degrees is equals to DG how much? 28.5 by BG is what? Addition. X plus Y. Clear? This implies we know tan 30 value how much? 1 by root 3 is equals to 28.5 by X plus from equation 1. From equation 1, what is the value of Y? 9.5 root 3 meters. 9.5 root 3. Clear? I replaced this value of Y from equation 1. 9.5 root 3. Now simply doing cross multiplication here. Then X plus 9.5 root 3. Doing cross multiplication. And this becomes what? 28.5 root 3 meters. So by doing what? Cross multiplication. We got this value. Here we have to find a value of X, right? Then X is equals to transposing this one to the RHS side. 28.5 root 3 minus 9.5 root 3 meters. This implies x equals to, same these two are irrational numbers, right? Root 3, root 3. Now you can subtract this one. 5 minus 5 is what? 0. 28 minus 9 is 19 and root 3. This implies x equals how much we got? 19 root 3 meters. Yes, x equals how much we got? 19 root 3 meters. This implies we know that root 3 value how much? 1.732 into 19. 9 2s are 18. 27 plus 1 is 28. 9 7 63. 65. 9 1s are 9. 9 plus 6 is 15. 1 2s, 3s, 7s, 1s. Adding 8, 10, 9, 12, 3. Decimal point after 3 digits, 1, 2, 3. So then x equals how much? 32.908 meters. That means what? X means what here? The distance traveled. Therefore, distance traveled or distance walked towards the temple is equals how much? 32.908 meters. Is it clear? So why I took here xy means it to understand easily. If you want to means you can take directly here total distance is d and the walk distance x. If you do d minus x for this tan 30, you will get the same answer. Okay. So this is about what? Question number 2. Question number 3. A statue stands on the top of a pedestal from a point on the ground. The angle of elevation of the top of the statue is 60 degrees and from the same point, the angle of elevation of the top of the pedestal is 45 degrees. Find the height of the statue. Okay, once again we will see the question. A statue stands on the top of a pedestal. A statue stands on the top of a pedestal. From a point on the ground, the angle of elevation of the top of the statue is 60 degrees. Okay. So from a point on the ground, the angle of elevation of top of the statue is how much? 60 degrees. And from the same point, the angle of elevation of top of the pedestal, second case, top of the pedestal is 45 degrees with the same point. Find the height of the statue. We had to find the height of the statue. Right? So once again, what we are doing here, this height of the boys, temples, temple and water tower, we are taking this form. So we are not drawing the full figure, right? Why means we know that all object towers or trees or buildings will consider as the linear object for our calculation purpose. Okay, we are not drawing a total terms, just I'm drawing a line. To consider as the linear objects for our mathematical convenience. Clear everyone? So what is it? A statue stands on the top of a pedestal. First we had to draw a pedestal. So just I'm drawing a line here. Thinking it is a pedestal. Is it clear? AB is the height of the pedestal. I'm considering as a linear object here, not drawing the pedestal. Simply, I'm assuming this was a pedestal AB. And what is said? Statue stands on the pedestal. AB is the pedestal. On this one, statue stands. Extending this one. Considering here C. Here BC is what? Statue. Is it clear everyone? AB is the pedestal and BC is the statue. And what is it? From a point on the ground, the angle of elevation of the top of the statue is 60 degrees. Taking a point on the ground, suppose here the point. Taking the point on the ground, what is said? The angle of elevation of top of the statue. So this is a ground. First it is a ground. Here point joining this one. So this one ground, this point I am considering as D here. Now joining here. The angle of elevation from this point is how much? 60 degrees. Is it clear? Next, what is it? and from the same point, means again considers point D, the angle of elevation of top of the pedestal is 45 degrees. Here B is the top of the pedestal. From the same point, now the angle of elevation is how much? 45 degrees. Is it clear? Now what do you have to find? Find the height of the statue. We have to find this height of the statue. Clear everyone? So you have to understand the figure compulsory. So now we'll do the solution with respect to the figure. First we'll write the given data. What are you given? Given data is given what? Height of the pedestal. Height of the pedestal. How much? What is here? AB is equal to 2 meters. Yes, sir. On top of a 2 meters pedestal. 2 meters is missing. So I know that one, right? So just I went off directly here. So given that the height of the pedestal AB is what? How much? 2 meters. So given here, 2 meters is the height of the pedestal. Okay, and what he said, we had to find the height of the statue, not given the height, right? Let height of the statue what is it? BC is equals to, we'll consider height as h meters. Considering height as h meters. Is it clear? And given angle of elevations. Angle of elevations from the point, nothing but given only point, one point, nothing but same point. What is the elevations given? 60 degrees and 45 degrees. Is it clear? Now we'll write here angle of elevation of top of statue. Top of the statue is equals how much? Top of the statue, how much is it? 60 degrees. Right? And angle of elevation of top of pedestal is how much? 45 degrees. Here 2 is given, one is the statue and one is the pedestal. So writing separately, so 60 degrees and it is a 45 degrees. Clear? Now we'll write here. So we don't know, first we have to find the distance of, first we'll find the base here. Nothing but distance between the point to the pedestal. Let the distance between the points, between the point of observation nothing but on the ground, right, observation and the pedestal nothing but foot of the pedestal, we'll assume as x meters. So this distance we'll consider as x meters. Okay, here what is actually DA indicates here? The distance between the foot of the pedestal to the observation point. Right? I'm considering as here x meters. From triangle, we will observe here from triangle BDA. From triangle BDA from 45, with respect to 45, side opposite to the adjacent. Again, side opposite to the adjacent, we have to consider the which ratio? Tan ratio. Right? Tan theta is equal to what is the opposite here? Opposite is what? AB by what is the adjacent here? AD. And theta, what's the measure of theta here? 45. Then tan 45 degrees is equal to AB. AB is the height of the pedestal is 2 meters by AD is the distance is how much? X. This implies we know that tan 45 how much? 1 is equal to 2 by X. This implies x is equal to how much? 2 meters. Here what is x indicates? The distance between the point of observation to the foot of the pedestal. We got x equals how much here? 2 meters. Now, we'll find the height of the statue. We'll find the height of the statue. From triangle total CDA. From triangle CDA. Nothing but with respect to 60, again, side opposite to the adjacent. Again, we had to consider tan ratio only. Then tan theta is equal to what is the opposite here? AC by adjacent is what? AD. Clear? Clearly we know here. How will you get AC value? AC is the total height. Nothing but how will you get AB plus BC? Okay? Nothing but AC indicates what? Height of the pedestal plus height of the statue. Right? AC is equal to, now we can say AB plus BC. Now tan theta value, how much now? Tan 60 here is equal to AC, nothing but how much? 2 plus H. 2 plus H. AB plus BC. AB is 2, BC is H. Nothing but 2 plus H by AD is X. X means how much already got here? 2. You will write here AC indicates here AB plus BC by AD is what? Here X. AB plus BC nothing but 2 plus H I written. By x means we got from equation 1, already we got x equals how much? 2 I replaced here. This implies tan 60. We know tan 60 value how much? Root 3 is equals to 2 plus h by 2. Is it clear? Now doing cross multiplication, 2 into root 3, 2 root 3 is equals to 2 plus h. Now we had to find the value of h right here. We had to find the height of the statue, nothing but h. This implies h is equals to 2 root 3 plus, if you transpose to the right side, plus quantity becomes minus 2. This implies h is equals to, here you can take 2 as a common factor, then 2 into root 3 minus 1. 2 into root 3, 2 root 3 minus 2 1s are 2. This implies h is equals to 2 into, we know that the root 3 value how much? 1.732 minus 1. Then h is equals to 2 into, so how much we will get? 1 minus 1 is 0, 0.732. Okay, subtracting whole number part, decimal part I am writing as it is. 1.732, nothing but here what is there here? 1 only there, nothing but 1.000, subtraction, then 1237, 1 minus 1 is 0, we got here. This implies h is equals to multiplication, 2 2 is the 4, 2 3 is the 6, 2 7 is the 14, 1 is the carry, 4 and 2 0 is the 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. Then height is equal to how much? 1.464 meters. So what indicates here h? Therefore height of the statue is equal to 1.464 meters. Is it clear? So, first you have to understand the figure, how to draw the triangle, then take the angle of elevation, substitute, you will get the answer. Right? So, this is about what? Exercise 12.2, first 3 questions. Right? Is it clear? Okay, if you have any doubt, please do in comment section, I will try to explain. I hope you got it. Thank you so much.